Track number two is, of course, called, don't get the wrong idea, ladies, My Draws. Take it away, player.
Whose draws?
My draws.
Okay, so I like the transition between the first song and this one. They kind of just mold into one another. I think that's quite cool. Interestingly, as I said in the start of the show, the only songs I heard on this album initially were the ones on Purple Rain, which were Jungle Love and Bird. And I could not get a copy of this all the way up until the mid-90s. But I did hear this track because it was the B-side to the Chocolate Maxi CD single. And so that was the first time I heard this song. It wasn't on this album, but on the B-side of Chocolate.
But this was also the B-side to something on this album as well, wasn't it?
I think so.
One of the other singles on this album was the B-side for that too.
Yeah.
So it's been twice.
Yeah, that's right. So, you know, you hear a song like Chocolate and then it's back to back with this. You definitely, again, hear that thinness. But this is a really cool song. I really like the lead line on this song. I like the guitar. It's kind of that really 1999 Purple Rain era Prince guitar. And the drums, the fills.
Morris Day's great on the drums. The fills are great.
No, I mean, like the drums are really standout. Like it's got good fills and all that.
Morris, a funky drummer.
Oh, Morris is an awesome drummer. And I've got in my notes here, this song is sophisticated. Not because it's a sophisticated song, but just in terms of its arrangement. There's lots of things going on all at once, but it all seems to like fit like a puzzle. So when you listen to it, it's not like, oh, that sounds odd or whatever. It just sounds like it's part of the song. So it's sophisticated in its terms of arrangement. I really like that. So I really like this song. It's a good song, but again, it just sounds thin.
Okay. With that, take it away, Tojay.
I think this is a sort of a solid track. It's probably the third best song on the album. It's got a classic knee-deep sort of synth hook line.
Yes.
Has, you know, that's just all over 1982, 83, 84, 85.
You're stealing my notes.
It's a classic 1984 wash of synths. You know, it reminds me of songs like Sugar Walls, like just these big wash of crazy synths. It's got a real bluesy, distorted bass and guitar riff. It runs through the song, and then it goes to that minor six, that dun-dun-dun, dun-dun-dun. That's kind of cool, but gets a little bit repetitive again. Listen, I reckon, to the background synths, the semiquavers going on behind the guitar solo. Jesse plays a crazy guitar solo on this.
And the guitar solo pans from left to right during that. Yeah.
Oh, yep. Cool. I hadn't noticed that. But yeah, there's like the background synths just real faintly in the background during this really fast semiquavers that ticka 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 ticka. That's really cool, that stuff. This song just reminds me of so many Prince songs. Like, I can't think of them specifically, but it's just got that sound. It's got the kind of chords he's using. It's got the sounds. It's got the drums. It's got the solos. There's one line there. There's that descending line that that sort of runs down. And that just reminds you of so many things Prince was doing that at that time. Da, 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 da. What's that? It's some Sheila E. song.
I was thinking the same thing. I was like, what is that from?
And I think the song Oh Sheila, which Prince had nothing to do, but it was sort of like an homage to the Prince Sheila E. collaboration. Like, it had a line just like that. So there's just so many things that just smack of 1984. So, I mean, in the plethora of 1984 songs, it's not like the most memorable thing, but it's something that when you hear it, you go, yeah, that's, you know, that's the Minneapolis sound. That's Prince in the time. So it's a good song for that. And it's got a funny ending. It just stops and someone walks down a hallway or something.
Cut. Yeah, this is a nasty groove, that's for sure. And I have to say that I can't, from the minute this song begins to the very moment that Toe Jam just described as this abrupt ending, I'm just bobbing my head to this like a maniac. When I first heard this, I thought it was Prince on the drums again. We know it's Morris now, but to players' comments, the drums are sick.
Save the clock tower.
Yeah, the drums are sick. There's no better. There's no bells in this song, but there are on the podcast if you listen carefully enough. But the drums are sick on this song. Filthy, filthy guitar playing by Jesse Johnson with a guitar solo. It is ridiculous. He is a maniac on the axe. He's such a unique guitar player. I don't know what it is. Like, not necessarily what he plays, but his sound. I don't know what he does, whether it's a combination of strings, pedals, and effects, and style. It doesn't matter. Let's not intellectualize it too much. He sounds freaking awesome on this. And his soloing throughout is kind of otherworldly. So bam, there, I said it. This is one of the best songs on this album, without a doubt. The only thing I will say is...
Wait, hold up. Did you say this is the best song in this album?
No, one of the best songs on this album.
Oh, one of. Okay.
Yeah, one of.
You're saving it for chili sauce, right?
Yeah. Maybe. I do like it hot, but yeah, Toe Jam mentioned that there was so much material released, so it's not top shelf material necessarily. And I think this is only the case because of how much music Prince released. Because I could see that if Prince released less material in 1984, this could have been a minor pop hit, certainly on the
maybe with
R&B chart.
I think I would say musically, potentially, but not with Morris's vocal and the lyrics.
No, it would have to be someone else's vocal, yeah.
Yeah, I think no offense to Morris, but I think if you strip away the lyrics and that Morris Day persona and you put like, you know, Sheena Easton or something like that on it, like you have a potential hit or like mini hit, you know.
Yeah, Sheena singing My Drawers though.
No, I'm saying like scrap the lyrics. Just, you know, you take just the groove. Okay. Yeah, like a different lead vocal, different song, but the same groove, you know. Yeah.
Like this song sounds, it's so early 80s Prince. It could have gone to Vanity or Apollonia. It ended up going to The Time. But with a female vocal, you know, maybe different lyrics, it could have done something. I mean, this reminds me of, this could have easily been a female vocal if this song had gone somewhere else.
All right. Well, speaking of going somewhere else, Captain, keep going. You're on the roll. What are your thoughts?
let's go. Like Player said, this just continues on from the last track. It's like the same note, the same key. The last song ends, this one goes, and it just keeps going. And I just think of this as a continuation of the first track, but it's just gone rock. That's cool. So yeah, we got Morris Day on drums. This is the only track on the album Morris plays drums. So that's something. Jesse Johnson on the guitars, which gives this the pretty heavy rock sound. Guitar solo is pretty crazy. There's some funkadelic stuff in there. It's either knee deep or get off your ass and jam. There's very similar things going on and it's very cool. But this song is just classic early Prince, classic Minneapolis sounds, rock guitars, and no one picked up on this yet, but there was hints of it. The main hook of this song, it's so similar to a bunch of things he did, but the one that I picked up was If I Was Your Girlfriend. Go and listen to that.
Oh yeah, you're right, yeah.
There's some very similar bits there which he reused in that. So that's cool. And I'd never noticed that until a few days ago. I was listening to it and I'm like, because from the first time I heard this song, I'm like, this sounds like a bunch of things. But it wasn't until a few days ago, I'm like, oh, that's what it is.
Even like 17 days. 17 days, same thing.
Yep. See, again, you talk about prolific, but there were so many things which were very similar, but just different enough for people to go, oh, look how many songs he wrote. But like at least half of them were almost the same.
You could say that about almost anyone, really.
But that's the personality. Like, you know, you listen to an artist long enough, you start to pick up little tricks and things that they do. Like, not a bad thing. It's kind of like, well, that's their sound, you know?
That's their signature thing, yeah.
Yeah.
But yeah, again, this track is also sort of similar to so many things. And yeah, you got the big guitar solo, panning left and right all over the place. That happens later on with other things on this album. And we'll get to that soon.
All right.